The recent exhibition celebrating LDS art gave me a chance to remember interesting art conservation restoration projects that we've preserved and restored over the years. Let me share some of these reflections with you. Our lab has enjoyed working with Anthony Christensen Fine Art for many years, and a period portrait of Brigham Young by Enoch Wood Perry on exhibition reminded me of the many, many portraits of this dynamic leader and prophet that have come under our care over the decades. This portrait came from the Beehive House. The contemporary paintings of historical scenes reminded me of the important work we've done with CCA Christensen's National Treasures. This is one of the exhibits with the CCA Christensen paintings showing the persecution of the Mormons. And we didn't try to restore these to their perfect condition. You can see there's still drips on them. But really quite presentable and stabilized, and of course very much tell the story. This is also by CCA Christensen, and love this painting. This is not part of that large series by the pioneers, but very nicely done. And here's an old friend that we resurrected. This was in really bad condition with really discolored varnish and several holes in it. Brigham Young calling volunteers for the Mormon Battalion, also done by CCA Christensen. I found this well-known image on display at Tony Christensen's, Gary Smith's rendition of the martyrdom. These are some other favorites of mine in the exhibition. Robert Barrett's Prayer in the Desert, this lovely stained glass window. I love all of Nikki Covington's classical styled sculptures. This one is entitled, Come, I Will Make You Fishers of Men. Michael Malm's painting, Five Were Wise, I thought was magical. This iconic painting by Minerva Tykert was also on exhibition, but belongs to the Springville Museum of Art for whom we do work. Seeing this reminded me of the many paintings we have enjoyed having in our lab over the years. I worked on this famous painting in 1980. I've always loved Tykert's Book of Mormon paintings, and we've worked on many. This is Alma Baptizing in the Waters of Mormon. This is Arnold Freeberg's study for his Alma Baptizing in the Waters of Mormon. His sketches were very interesting to see on display, and they're for sale. Here's one of Laban. His study of Moroni reminded me of a project of restoring the front page of the architectural drawings of the Los Angeles Temple. His depiction of Moroni is powerful, and it's interesting to note the drawing that was on display at Tony Christensen's of the sculptural design around the front door of the temple that was never executed. This recent exhibition celebrating LDS art recalled to my mind these interesting art conservation and restoration projects, and many more, that we've preserved and restored over the years. There's a great amount of professional and personal satisfaction in having contributed to the preservation and optimum appearance of the heritage and culture of Mormon art for generations to come.